Hello everyone. So guys, my name is Pawan and today we'll be learning about what are Central Council of Ministers and State Council of Ministers. Along with that, the importance of cabinet that also we'll be trying to study. So guys, very important for you to note, Article 74 of the Constitution of India tells us about the status of Council of Ministers, and Article 75 speaks about the appointment, tenure, responsibility, qualifications, oath and salaries in terms of Council of Ministers. Now, that's not very important for you to note down, but for you to understand, I've made 4 points for you. You can write the same thing for your exams too. It's still fine. So what do you call by Central Council of Ministers? CCM. I kept a short form called as CCM. So the Prime Ministers and the Central Council of Ministers advises the President, who will exercise its functions. So what is the main role of CCM? That is the Central Council of Ministers, that is like Prime Minister. And if I'm the Prime Minister, accounting to me, there will be many Council of Ministers. They will be advising whom? The President. Second thing is that the advice rendered shall not be inquired in any court. That means that, for example, if the President cannot tomorrow file a complaint stating that this advice was given by this minister, this advice was given that minister, so I'm not responsible, this particular minister is responsible. Nothing like that. There's nothing like that, because advice rendered shall not be inquired in any part of the court. You cannot go to the court and file a case, because it is one of the confidential relationship between the CCM versus the President. Third important thing is that every minister shall have right to speak and take part in proceedings, either house, joint sitting of the house, or any claim of the parliament. So every minister shall have the right to speak and take part in the proceedings. That means that all the members of the CCM have complete rights to ask questions, proceedings. Either they can sit in the joint house or in basically in the other house. Either houses or in terms of the parliament. Fourth important aspect is President cannot exercise executive powers without aid and advice of the Council of Ministers. Exactly, guys. Guys, in India, we are not following dictatorship regime. Nothing like that. Okay, in India, we are basically giving the voice of the people. So over here, President cannot exercise, he cannot take any decision without the functionalities and the power of the CCM. So guys, these are the first important 4 components which you need to keep in mind about CCM. Now let's go to the selection of the Central Council of Ministers. Now the first one which you need to keep in the mind is that the Prime Minister is appointed by President, but other CCM, Prime Minister is basically appointed by whom? President. But the other Central Council of Ministers, you know, are appointed by the President on the consultation with the Prime Minister. Obviously, it's a Prime Minister. See now, very important. See, if you're able to understand this properly in your guys, the same replica happens for your State Council of Ministers too. Now, I explained in my previous video also, in case you have not watched about functions of President and Chief Minister, not, please do check it out. See, who appoints the Prime Minister? President appoints the Prime Minister. Now, who will appoint this Council of Ministers? The President will appoint these Council of Ministers, but only with the consultation of the Prime Minister. Obviously, the names list will be off based on the wish list of the Prime Minister. Second thing is that, see, these Council of Ministers should not exceed beyond 15% of the Lok Sabha. Third thing is that the Central Council of Ministers are responsible for Lok Sabha. All the actions of Lok Sabha, these CCM members are responsible. Fourth important aspect is the salaries are determined by the President. So what is the salaries of these Central Council of Ministers? It is actually determined by whom? It is determined by the President. So fifth important point is that the person who is not either in Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha can be a member, but within 6 months he or she should be in one of the houses. For example, I think one of the example, I'm not sure though this example works out, but our finance minister, you know, Nirmala Sitaramanji, she's not an elected person, right? She does not come under one, yeah, she comes under this one BJP regime, but yes, still she is not coming from elected this one, but she's coming as an external source, this one, right? External source and intervention. I mean, like, if I just tell in the same way, there's no kind of election done in terms of Nirmala Sitaramanji. She was basically selected by the party. Now, got it? Now, at that point of time, she was not in Lok Sabha, neither Rajya Sabha. So she had 6 months time duration to either choose to be in one of the houses of the parliament. Got it? This is the sixth important point. Now, seventh important point is that if a minister is against cabinet decision, he must resign. Yes, guys, if a minister is against the cabinet decision, then he must resign. Eighth important point is the President can remove a minister with the advice of the Prime Minister. President, any member of the Council of Ministers can be removed very easily by the President with the consultation of whom? With the consultation of the Prime Minister, obviously. Next point is basically about, you know, during no confidence motion, all the CCM resign signs from both the Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Yeah, during no confidence motion, all the members should basically resign. That is compulsory. And in the CCM, no, like I've just jumbled up with numbers, but however you can relate and learn, right? And the ninth point is about composition of CCM. So in the Central Council of Ministers, we do have cabinet ministers, we have health minister, defense minister, deputy ministers. All these are the composition of the CCM. I hope now you got a complete clarity out of it. If we just quickly summarize, in CCM, PM is appointed by president, but president appoints all the CCM members. It should not exceed beyond 15% of cap limit. All the CCM members should be responsible for Lok Sabha. All the salaries have been determined by the president. The person who's not in the in either house of Lok Sabha or Rajya Sabha, they have 6 months time duration to enter into the houses. Sixth point is that during no confidence motion, if all should resign from that house, Lok Sabha and Rajya Sabha. Seventh one is that if a member is against the decision of the cabinet decision, then he must be resigned. Eighth point is that the president can remove a minister with the advice of the prime minister. So basically president can remove anyone with the advice of the prime minister. So guys, the composition of the CCM is basically like, it could be like cabinet ministers, like health minister, defense minister, minister of state and affairs. So guys, this is the overall summarizing of the Central Council of Ministers. Now let's quickly learn about the role of the cabinet. See guys, the same replica happens for state council of ministers, like within the state level also the cabinet. See, if you understand the center properly, you know, state is very easy. Role of cabinet, this cabinet is also called as kitchen cabinet and Westminster model of cabinet. That you just need to keep in your mind, but it's like very, very less members compromises of a cabinet. See, in cabinet only we have finance minister, health minister, defense minister, education minister, like in case of education minister is there, education minister. So all these ministers compromises of a cabinet, and who presides over here? Obviously the prime minister. Now there are eight important points you need to keep in the mind. All the decision making, they are the main core decision making authorities within the cabinet. Got it? Second thing is that chief policy formulating body of the central government. So the cabinet plays a chief policy formulating body of the central government. First one is decision making. Second one is the chief policy formulating. Third one is that supreme exclusive autonomy is there with these people. So in the cabinet, they have supreme exclusive authority. Fourth point is about chief coordinator of the central administration. All the coordination of the central administration has been done by them. So decision making, chief policy formulating, supreme exclusive authority. That means complete authority is basically there in their hands. Fourth one, chief coordinator of the central administration. Fifth one is about administrative body. They are the place very administrative bodies for the overall welfare of the country. Now sixth point is that they are the chief of the crisis management, all kind of crisis management. Like guys, little apologies for the this one. I think some words have just written as short forms, just for me to understand very quick way. But however, for you can in the upcoming days I'll make a very good video. But for the time being, just remember these things. Seventh point is that they are the legislative and financial powers. All the legislative and financial powers has been taken care by cabinet. Eighth point is that they deal with foreign policies and foreign affairs also. So very important thing, decision making, chief policy formulating, supreme exclusive authority, chief coordinating of central administration. Fifth one, administrative body, chief of crisis management, legislative and financial powers, and deal with foreign policies and foreign affairs. The demerits of this cabinet is that it is a dictatorship. There can be dictatorship, and there can also be an influence of an outside person. So that means that I hope whose name I already gave this example before, so I don't want to repeat it. But yeah, there could be also be dictatorship in this regime. So guys, this is the role of the entire cabinet.